Let's take a look at chapter four. And chapter four is all about decisions. And specifically, we'll be looking for the bulk of the chapter, looking at if statements and different types of if statements. And then towards the back, we'll see like a switch statement, how that works. But for the most part, we're talking about ifs. And so for this chapter, you notice something a little bit different. I mean, we still have our video links down here. These are from the author. And then you have your assignments, and then of course my programming lab, and then PowerPoints and all that stuff. But you'll notice that the dates on these are all March 17th. So you've got a couple weeks to work on these. I've been splitting up the chapters, but for this one, I just decided to just throw everything in at once and just let you go for it. Now, there's a lot in this chapter, so don't wait until March 17th to start working on this. All right, so try and work on some, maybe try and get through some of the assignments by next week. And anyway, that we won't have anything due next week. I thought about making the 10th the due date for some of these, but then I thought no, I'll just let them all be due the same day. So anyway, so split them up. Don't wait till the last minute to work on this. Now, I want to mention the section over here for my programming lab. You'll see there's quite a few things. So just in 4.1, there's quite a few little things to practice. Some of them I don't have as many, but I thought this section was good practice. And then you'll see it kind of goes down from here. So again, there's quite a few things to work on in here in my programming lab. So again, don't wait till the last minute to start working on those. Okay, let's see. Oh, also make sure, hopefully you guys are following along and commenting, doing those kinds of things. Make sure you're taking a look at the instructions. In fact, since I mentioned the switch statement, let's go ahead and look at the Roman numeral converter program. And if I just roll over here, you'll see this is what you're going to do. So a range of 1 to 10, use the switch statement to display the Roman numeral version of that number. So specifically using a switch. So make sure you're looking for things like that in there. I want to see that your code will work with a switch statement, and that you've coded it properly, so you're mixing it up a little bit. So on some of them, I'll throw in little things like that. The input validation, this is sort of the first chapter where you'll be able to check. So you can write if statements to check to make sure that the user has entered, if you're asking for a number between 1 and 10, that they've actually entered that number. Now, if they don't enter that number, the program ends. You can give them a little message or whatever, and then the program will end. You have to start it again. But next chapter, when we do loops, you'll see doing error checking. What'll happen is you'll ask for a specific number. If they don't put that in there, then you can say, hey, just a little reminder, you entered the wrong thing, whatever it might be. You entered the number 12 or whatever, and but you've got to enter the number 1 through 10, and then it will ask again. So it will loop and run through again. So that's, again, that's the next chapter. But at least you get to play with it this chapter and kind of see how that works. And I don't know, I think it's kind of fun. It starts adding more to your toolbox that you can use in realistic programming. So I think that's kind of cool. So anyway, if you have any questions about this particular chapter, let me know. Otherwise, have fun with decisions.